Thank you very much. Good evening, Las Vegas, Nevada. Woo! So nice for all of you to join us tonight, man. We wanted to do something a little bit different for you this time around, and I don't know who was here the last time, but what matters is we are all here together to release the same kind of energy, yes? And, you know, we come through here a lot and we bring the full bells and whistles, but tonight we thought we'd get a little bit more intimate, personal with you, a little closer to you. Thought we'd try a couple of new things. For one, you know, we're gonna tell you about some of these songs and what they meant to us when we wrote them. And for two, we thought maybe we'd go out there with a microphone and see if any of you guys have any questions for us, all right? So before we do that, let's play some music.
Thank you.
Thank you. So this next piece we're gonna do for you guys here, this was a song that was written at a very weird point in this band's career. As you guys know, our first record came back out, and it came out in 1998, and thanks to people like yourselves, it did really well, so thank you for that. But on the downside, what happened was it kept us out on the road for quite a long time, and we ended up writing the second record while we were touring on the first record, and that ended up turning into about 4.5 years of being away from home and family and friends. We went into a very dark place as a band. We were fighting a lot, we were arguing, we were, you know, even mix that with a little bit of drugs and alcohol, and all of a sudden we get to a point where the band was about this close to breaking up forever. But instead of letting egos get in the way and that kind of thing, we decided to do the right thing instead of the selfish thing and stay together and get some help so we could be here with you guys today. And this is a song that we wrote during that period, man. This is a song called Running Blind. So I think we should set the tone for this evening, man. We have A man I think you met earlier by the name of, well, we call him Gary Springer. Where are you, Gary?
In the barricade for the first time
ever. What's up, man? So listen, we're going to go out. Is anybody out here ever wanted to ask the band a question? Anybody in the band? Something through fan mail or email or in person that you just couldn't quite get across to us? Now is your chance. Listen up. There's only a couple rules to this, all right? One, don't ask us where we get the name of the band because it's a boring old question. Two, don't ask us about religion. And three, if you ask anything stupid, you go into the penalty box for 2 minutes, all right? Who's up?
You pick it.
She right here, front and center, white shirt. What's your name?
My name is Samantha.
Samantha.
Yes, sir. Hi, Sully. Hi. I was wondering how the Navy got a hold of Awake.
Oh, the Navy. They contacted, someone in the Navy likes us because they contacted our management company and asked to use one of the songs, their recruit commercial. And the cool thing is they just re-upped it for another 3 years with Sick of Life. Come on with it. Anybody else? Striped shirt, all the way down.
Striped shirt.
What's your name?
My name's Angie.
Angie.
Where'd you get the inspiration?
Could you turn up her mic a little bit in my ears? There you go.
Where'd you get the inspiration for Serenity?
You know, it's funny you say that. When we were writing the Faceless record, I was reading a book called The Ghost Rider that was written by a man that me and Mr. Shannon Larkin here were very influenced by, called Neil Peart from a band called Rush. Any Rush fans? Yeah, so I was sitting there. Tony had come up with this really beautiful piece of acoustic music, and I was reading this book called The Ghost Rider. And although it's not my place to tell his story, what I can tell you is back in 1998, Neil Peart went through a very severe tragedy involving his wife and his child. And what I found more inspiring about the book wasn't so much about the tragedy part of it. It was about how this man got on a motorcycle and drove 55,000 miles in 14 months in search of a reason to live. And he was able to heal himself. And what I thought was really amazing about that is that us as individuals, you know, we have this built-in instinct to be able to do that and heal ourselves no matter how bad things get at times, instead of doing the wrong thing and tying a noose around your neck or whatever. That's kind of how it all came together, man. So it's called The Ghost Rider. You can get it on Amazon.com. It's an amazing book. You guys should check it out. And this is Serenity.
Thank you. thoughts mean nothing, and when will we learn to control? I need serenity.
Just don't.
I need serenity. I need serenity. I need serenity.
Thank you. So if any of you are wondering who this handsome son of a bitch is right here sitting on our love seat, his name is Lee Richards, and there's actually a story here to Lee, man. Lee was the original guitar player in Godsmack back in 1995. I guess what happened, is it okay if I tell this? You don't mind?
That makes you look good anyways. You'll get all the women tonight.
What happened with Lee was about a year into the band, man, he got the knock on his door, which every man fears, which was a lady on the other end with a little boy said, "This is your child. I need some help financially. Please do the right thing." He actually came to me and Robbie and he said, "Guys, it's been really cool, man. I've had a great time. But you know what? I have this 6-year-old boy that I never knew existed, and I have to leave the band and go support him." So very honorably and very well done. Kudos to Lee. This next song we're gonna do for you is this and Serenity were probably the only two songs that I ever wrote lyrically that had absolutely nothing to do with my own life. This one I actually found some inspiration through a movie I watched called The Serpent and the Rainbow by Wes Craven. Nightmare on Elm Street, dude, you know? If you haven't seen it yet, you should pick it up because it's a very cool movie about voodoo.
I'm not the one who's so far away when I feel the snake bite and tear my veins. Never did I wanna be here again, and I don't remember why I came.
Bite and tear my veins. Never did I want.
Thank you. So, what do you say we go out into this crazy audience one more time? See if you guys got anything else on your minds you want to ask the band? Anybody out there? Gary, where are you?
Upstairs.
Are you upstairs?
Yeah.
Where are you?
To your right, right up here.
Hi. You're all in black, dude. You got to start wearing like fluorescent green or something. I can't see you.
Nope.
So, we're going to do this one more time. Anybody got something they want to ask? You pick it. What's your name?
My name is James.
What's up, man?
I want to know how you guys kick ass so hard.
With my cowboy boots. Penalty box for him.
Farther to the right.
All right. You got one?
Yeah, way over here. Anybody over here?
Oh, there you are. Okay. You got someone for me. What's your name?
It's Edie.
Hi.
Hi. I have a bit of a personal question.
Okay.
How are the kids?
The kids are fine.
Yeah?
Growing very quickly, running around and talking like crazy. Shannon's is 6 going on 20. Mine's 3 going on 15. Anybody else?
Let's do
this one more
side.
Time. What, you didn't? Well, I thought I put you in the penalty box, dude. Going once. Go, how about this guy right here in the green shirt? I know he has something stupid to say, but I'm going to hear him anyways. I can just tell. You got that look on your face.
Can I come up there and play the tambourine, dude?
What's your name?
I'm Larry.
Larry.
Last time I saw you guys, you warmed up for Metallica. How does it feel to outperform Metallica?
Wow. I don't know if that's a question or a statement, but thank you. But to answer your question, man, I want to tell you this. This band right here has been following that band for over 20 years, man, and it is a blessing and an honor to share the same stage with them. I'll tell you that much. These guys are true veterans, man. This is a song about reincarnation.
I don't know.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Robbie Merrill. working on the drums.
Smack me in my
Well, I guess you guys aren't going home yet, huh? Good, because we ain't done. I just want to say that I hope you guys enjoyed tonight as much as we enjoyed playing for you. This is a very special kind of show for us, you know, and we want to thank you guys for allowing us to be able to perform acoustically for you. And we are going to take a little bit of a long break after this year, man. We've been out for 18 months now, and we are going to come back in the fall of next year with Godsmack 4 for you. So, you guys remember earlier when I introduced you to this gentleman right here, Mr. Lee Richards. Handsome devil you are. God, must be a curse. Handsome and talented.
Water up in Massachusetts.
Yeah, it's the water up in Boston. He's from Boston too, man. He's Boston boy. How about them Red Sox, huh? Woo! I want to introduce you to another gentleman. This is Lee's partner in crime. His name is Mr. John Costco. Check this out. Good job, Vegas. Thank you very much. All right, you know what? We were going to end it there, man. I'm just not ready to go yet. I'm just not ready. I'm in the beer drinking mood. You're in the beer drinking mood, right? We need some beer drinking music to close this out, man. We're in the House of Blues, Las Vegas, Nevada. Let's do something that got some soul to it, brother.
Let's jam.
Some blues, baby.
Yeah. When that good love
gadgets to get me half as high.